Hello my dear students, this is Shilpi Saxena. So agenda of this video is using Python libraries, in which I will be explaining what is library, module, function, how to import modules and namespace. So we are going to start with library. So library is a collection of functions, methods that allow you to perform many actions without writing your code. See, functions, I have already explained what are functions. So when you create a function, so it is in a file, that is a Python file. The function, you are very well aware what is function. When you create a function, you keep it in Python file. That Python file with the extension py is known as module. So each and every file which you are storing with the extension py is a module. When, suppose for example, you are in class 12th and you have created a folder of class 12 science. So, and you have kept all your programs in that particular folder. So that folder is a package. That folder is a package. So, and that if that folder is a subfolder of your school, in that case, that main folder is known as library. So in short, library is a collection of package, which is a collection of module, and which is a collection of functions. So Python, in Python, library and package are almost same. They can be used interchangeably, and we can change the name of package to library or library to package. Just to differentiate between two, I have taken this example. So Python library is a collection of functions, methods that allow you to perform many actions without writing code. So commonly used libraries which are available in Python are standard library. See, standard library is which we don't have to install it. It is pre-installed. We just have to import this library. Like it contains math module. Math module like POW, that is power, SQRT, flow, seal, different predefined functions are used, are there, which we can use for calculation purpose. Next is CMath. It provided mathematical functions for complex number. Complex number, you must be aware, A plus IB type of numbers are complex number. To handle those number, we have CMath module. Then random. This I'll explain in my further videos. Random is a random is a module which can generate random numbers between the specified range. Then comes statistics module, which will provide all the statistics functions. Then comes urlib. So urlib, I have not mentioned here. This urlib I will cover completely in my next video. Then comes NumPy library. It is used to handle arrays. Now arrays are basically just like list. The only difference between list and array is, array is a collection of homogeneous elements and list is a collection of heterogeneous elements. Means list can contain different kind of elements like integer along with string, along with another list, along with tuple, anything we can have. But the array is a collection of similar kind of elements. So to handle those arrays, we have NumPy library. Then come SciPy library, that is science library. It is basically used for image processing, integration, linear algorithm. Next come Tikenter library. This library is not in your syllabus. SciPy is also not in your syllabus, but Tikenter I will cover in my further videos because it will be helpful when you will create your project. So it is basically used for graphic designing. So if suppose for example you want to book, you want to develop a project of ticket booking system in which cinema ticket booking system in which you want to show the seats, you can use this library to create the buttons. And this will be very helpful for you. And next library is Matplotlib library, that is used basically for graphs. So next come module. I already explained module is any file with the extension py. Whatever files you are creating, whatever programs you are saving, that is a module. Then comes structure of module. See, structure, it contains doc string, variables and constraint, classes, objects, statements and functions. Doc string is basically the comment used, which you are using in triple quotes, the variables and constraints, that is identifier and literals, classes and objects. Class is a collection of functions along with variables, and objects are variables of type class. It can contain statements, normal statement and functions. So if you want to see what all your module have, suppose I've taken an example, suppose this is our program, this is a program, okay. So what you can do is, this is a program, suppose you can see this is a doc string, these are two functions. So I'll run this program. It contains simply the two functions. So if you want to know about the structure of this particular module, you have to use the command help module. But help module you cannot use directly, you have to first import it. Import module. Module is the name of file. See, you can see here module.py. You can see here it is module.py. So import module. After that we can use help module, and then you can see help on module, the name, it will contain the name of module. So the module name is again a module only. I have written the same name. And then the description is, you can see the doc string which I use. This program finds factorial of a number and area of a circle. Then what all functions I have used, and the location of file. See, the D drive, Shilpi, Python, libraries and module.py. So all these things are given in the when we use help module. Secondly, see, you can see here you have used comment. Single line comment is not given. Suppose I have written it in triple quotes. In that case, if after that again I will use help. Just a minute. 5. Again, I can use this. So import module and then help. You can see now whatever comment I wrote in factorial function, you can see here factorial of a number, that will be shown. So the next thing is, I'll close this, then move, we will move ahead. The next thing is the function. Function, already I covered everything. It is a collection of different statement. We have, if we want, we can break the program into different functions which we can call as and when required. So I will, next thing is how to import module. Before import, telling you about importing module, I will just quick recap it. Whatever, if you want to make a small program which you can call again and again, that is a function. It contains the normal statements, and suppose addition of a number, if you want to add multiple time, you can just call the function. A program can have multiple function. That program you have to store it with the extension py. So all the Python file you are storing it with the extension py is module. If you have created a folder of your name on your desktop or laptop and saved all the Python files there, so that you can easily take out that, open that folder and find all your files, that particular folder is known as package. And that particular package, so you are in 12th standard, suppose your teacher has created a 12th science folder in which she has created the different folder of all the students, that 12th science folder is known as library. Now we will move ahead with importing modules. To import module, we can import entire module, or we can import single object. We can import multiple objects also. So to start with it, I'll show you. Suppose I have written a program. This is a small program in which we can directly import a module. You can see here, when you import any module, you have to take care both should be at the same location. It should be at the same location in the main, either in the main Python folder, or if you have created the folder, whatever you are importing, it should be in the at the same location. Otherwise, it will generate an error, module not found. So I already created. See, in the, I'll show you the folder. Suppose I have created a folder here in which there are three files. Importing is my main file, then module and root. Root is a file which will calculate the root, nth root of a number. This function I have created. Then comes module which will calculate the factorial, calculate the factorial and area of a circle. And then comes importing, that is the main function. So we can import the module, and I have written a program ans is equal to y while ans is equal to 1, ans equal to 1 while this is to run infinite loop till we are entering 1 here in the ans, it is going to run this code. So what do you want to do? Factorial of a number, nth root of a number, or area of a circle? Whatever, if suppose you have entered 1, so it will call, this is the method to this. You can just see the statement. If you want to call a function, this factorial function from module, you have to write module.factorial. This is the module name followed by dot and the function name which you want to use. So I'll just run this program, function F5, enter your choice, suppose 1. Nth root of a number, suppose I have entered 5, it will calculate the factorial. Do you want to continue? Enter 1 to continue. Suppose I want to calculate nth root of a number, enter value of base, enter value of power, it will calculate 5 raised to 1 by 3 is this. Then 1 to continue, you want to calculate area of a circle, then will ask for the radius and area of a circle is shown. So you can see here the output. Now to exit, I'll just write 2, it will come out of the loop. Now if you want, you can also import a single module by writing from module. Import factorial. So it will import only one function. So function is, now if we will run this, so it will not allow you, it suppose choice is 1, it will calculate module not defined. Because so if we are using this from import from module import factorial, in that case we don't have to use module.factorial, because in this case when we import the using from module import factorial single function or two functions or three functions, in that case we don't have to specify the module name. It can be used directly. If we will specify module name, it will generate an error. Now if we will run, you can see here factorial of a number 1, enter choice 1 because I want to calculate factorial, and it will calculate the factorial. If press 1 to continue, now if I will try to use second option, in that case it will generate an error because I have not imported it. Similarly, we can import multiple objects also. If you want, you can use nth root also. Now we are importing multiple functions. Now if I'll run, you can see cannot import nth root from module because we have used this root dot nth root.
which we have not imported yet. That in module, what we have, area dot circle. That is why it has generated an error. I'll just copy it, because we have to take care that in that module which particular function exists. Now next thing is, this module is again, it will generate an error because it is, we have used module function F5. You can see, suppose enter 3, it will generate an error, module is not defined. To save your program from error, you have to remove this F5 again, enter your choice 3, now radius, and it will calculate the radius. See, when why this is happening, because when we are importing any function using from module import for this particular function, in that case it will create the namespace inside the main namespace. Now we'll go to the concept of namespace. See, namespace is a system to have a unique name for each and every object in Python. When we are creating any program, when we are running any program, the namespace is the area that is dedicated to that particular module, that particular object, that particular function, that particular variable. And the name of that namespace is exactly same as the name of the module or name of the object. So when we are using import, there are different namespace. It is same as I explained in LEGB rule in my previous video. So when we are using, you can see here, I will show you this one. When you will use this import module, in that case whole module we are importing. When we import the whole module, this is the current namespace, that is this one, that is the main program. So this is the current namespace that is created, and separate namespace from the factorial which will have the variables x and f, which those were the local variables. So local namespace is created here, and this is a separate namespace when we are using import module. But when we are using from module import factorial, in that case separate namespace is not created, and all the functions and variables are the part of current namespace, main namespace. That is why in my last program you must have seen why we don't use module dot factorial. This is wrong. We will not use this directly. We have to use factorial directly. We can use factorial directly, we can use all the variables and functions.